Welcome to Armstrong Installation Training, vinyl composition tile. For best possible result, the substrate should be level, smooth and clean, free of parting or curing compounds, grease or paint. It should be dry to a minimum of 5.5% moisture or 70% relative humidity. The material should be acclimatized on site for at least 24 hours and approved substrates are concrete, plywood, or tempered masonite. One of the most important aspects of the job is the set out. Start by measuring the overall length and width of the room. In this example, the room is 3400 millimeters long and 2300 millimeters wide. Starting with the width of the room, 2300 millimeters will fit 7 300 millimeter tiles with 200 millimeters left over. By equalizing the room, this gives us a 100 millimeter cut piece at each wall. For a better visual, it's a good idea to remove another tile to make it 6 full tiles and a 250 millimeter cut at each wall. Using our calculations, measure 900 millimeters, which is 3 full tiles, plus 250 millimeters for our cut piece, and put a pencil mark on the floor. Repeat at the other end of the room, then strike a chalk line between the two marks. For the length of the room, 3400 millimeters will fit 11 full tiles, with 100 millimeters left over. Again, halving a full tile will give us a much better cut piece of 200 millimeters. It's very important to set out the room perfectly square, and one way to achieve this is to place a pencil mark on the chalk line as close as possible to the center. In this example, measure 6 full tiles. That's 1800 millimeters plus 200 millimeters for our cut piece. Using some material that won't stretch and our pencil mark as the center, mark an arc at 2 points along the chalk line. Then using those marks as a center, mark 4 arcs that intersect. Strike a chalk line through the 2 crosses, and this gives us a perfectly square set out. Armstrong pressure sensitive adhesive is specially formulated for vinyl composition tiles, and Armstrong S891 steel trowel has notches for both tile and sheet products. The reverse side has 0.8mm notches, which is perfect for VCT. Spread the adhesive evenly on one side of the room. Unlike sheet adhesive, pressure-sensitive adhesive must be allowed to dry before applying tiles. This system allows for large areas to be spread and long working time, provided the conditions are not windy or dusty. For best results, don't slide the tiles, but place them in this order. To trim the tiles, we use the equal overlap method. Start in the middle of the room to minimize runoff, and place a tile directly on top of another. Place a full tile against the wall and score a line with a sharp knife. Gently snap the tile along the line and fit the cut piece in place. Cutting around obstacles, such as pipes, can be achieved in the following manner. Ensure tiles are laid on at least 3 sides of the pipe to ensure accurate marking. In this example, we need to place a spacer tile so we can cut the third tile in the exact position. Using a full tile, put a pencil line from the pipe and both sides of the wall. Using a straight edge and a knife, cut along the wall marks and snap the tile. Place the cut piece either side of the pipe and using a full tile, mark both sides. Using dividers set to the 3 points, mark a circle on the tile. To cut out this shape, we need to heat the tile to make it more pliable. Always heat tiles from the back to minimize the risk of burning. For internal corners, it is important to start with the tile as close as possible to the width of the final piece. Using the equal overlap method, cut one side and then the other for a piece that fits perfectly. For external corners, again using the equal overlap method, mark the first side with a pencil. Score the second side with a knife. Then, when you know where the two lines intersect, score over the pencil line with a knife. For architraves and other difficult shapes, use the equal overlap method. Use a pencil for all the marks, as we don't know where they will intersect. Again, use heat to make the tile easier to cut. Upon completion, use a 45 kilo roller in both directions to ensure maximum bond. For an angled installation, find the center of the room in both directions and strike two chalk lines. Using material that won't stretch, mark four arcs across the lines. Then using those marks as a center point, mark intersecting arcs between those. Strike a chalk line between the crosses and the center to give us a perfect 45 degree angle. Spread the adhesive in half the room, wait for it to dry, and install the tiles in the correct order. For angle trimming, we can use the equal overlap method by cutting a piece of sheet vinyl to the exact dimensions of a tile, measured from point to point. Place one tile exactly on another. Use the sheet as a marker. Score and snap. Internal, external corners, and other difficult objects can be very difficult to fit when installing on a 45 degree angle, so it's a good idea to use a paper template. Cut a piece of template paper exactly to the size of a tile. Fit the paper tight to the other tiles and trim the paper down to about 10 millimeters short of the wall. Place a straight edge against the wall and mark on the paper with a pencil. Place the paper on a tile and using the straight edge, transfer the marks onto the tile. For architraves and larger, more difficult areas, use a larger piece of paper covering more than one tile. Place the required amount of tiles perfectly together and transfer the marks. Remove all debris and roll the entire area with a 45 kilo roller. Armstrong has a complete range of cleaning products for both coated and non-coated vinyls. Please allow 72 hours after the installation work is completed before doing any wet maintenance work. If the floor is badly soiled, a wet scrub is needed. Mop the floor with Armstrong once and done, and using a machine with a red pad, scrub the tiles before removing residue with a clean mop. To help add strength to the finished floor, it's a good idea to give it a dry buff using a red pad before applying polish. Remove any dust with a static broom. Apply a coat of Armstrong Premium Sealer and allow it to dry. Then apply at least two coats of Armstrong Shinekeeper polish, allowing it to dry completely between coats. Coating in different directions will help ensure even coverage. Once the polish is dry, buff the floor using a white pad. Regular maintenance should be carried out by mopping with a neutral detergent and occasional dry buffing with a white pad. If the floor becomes badly soiled, a wet scrub can be carried out using neutral detergent and a red pad. Following these installation and maintenance recommendations carefully will give you a beautiful trouble-free floor for many years to come.